I start, that's the beginning. Now I will look back and tell you my personal experience during the last 9 months. And I will tell you our experience in handling the corona pandemic in the German MPN group. Let us start in the past. At the beginning of March, the corona cases in Germany began to rise slowly. First, people died. My wife and I just came back from a journey and arrived at Munich Airport. We dropped our luggage at home and drove some hours later with a car south to the Bavarian Alps, where we have a smaller flat for the weekend. It is on the countryside where we can move around all the time. Close to us is a village called Wernsmühl. That's a very Bavarian name. In Wernsmühl, there's a 500 years old Gasthaus. Gasthaus means pub. Nägele is the name of the owner's family. This place, this photograph is for me a picture of the past, also for the kind of communication we used. When you live in a small village with some 100 people, you know nearly everybody and you talk to everybody. People live here, go to school, work here and die here. And you are familiar with each other. You know the sorrows and the pleasures of your neighbors. You even learn things about them you would prefer not to know. Let us look inside. You live in a huge family, sit together and share your daily life, your problems when you are sick or when you are sitting in a wheelchair. People are open, they need each other. Life is like it was ever. Most things happen analog. The picture illustrates for me like we patients met before the virus. I know this picture provides a romantic idea of support, but it shows what happens in our Munich MPN group after our monthly meetings. We went to a Greek restaurant nearby and we became friends over the years. We became familiar and learned from each other how to live with an MPN. Today, the corona pandemic changed our world in weeks. We were not allowed to meet again. We did not want to meet again. Our analog communication face to face stopped. We discovered digital remedies and solutions. This screenshot shows a new way of digital communication. People sitting in front of their computers and talk to each other, to virtual persons. It shows the GAIS and St. Thomas Virtual Patients Forum organized by MPN Voice, the English MPN group. The forum took place in August on a Saturday morning. 12 clinicians spoke, hundreds of patients participated. It was a great event, very impressive, organized by professionals. Our German MPN group has about 1,000 members. Before Corona, our members met during the year at different times in 23 regional groups all over Germany. Once a year, around May, about 150 members met with MPN specialists from Friday evening to Sunday afternoon. The lockdown began in Germany in the middle of March. Everything was prepared for our big annual meeting in May, but we had to cancel it. How did we support patients now? In the first weeks of the lockdown, everyone worried about his own situation. But after a while, we learned to live with the pandemic. In Germany, we run an internet forum for our patients. People shared started to share their experience online, their experience about the pandemic. That was the first step to what we call now the new normal. And we discovered Jitsi. Do you know Jitsi? Jitsi is a safe video software for free. It's easy to use. You learn it in 5 minutes. We started small video meetings. In the beginning, these meetings were not popular. Till today, more and more people learned to use it. Armin, a very engaged member, I hope Armin is listening now. Hello, Armin. Offered several meetings for new diagnosed patients. Leonard, a student, our youngest and very well-informed member. Leonard is 21, offered meetings for young patients. Antje, member of our board, organized video conferences, especially for women and about her experience with Besremi, the new interferon. And many of the 23 regional groups started regular smaller video meetings. It took us a long time, but now we found a replacement of the canceled annual meeting. We offer now 4 MPN webinars, each 90 minutes, with 8 specialists. We started last Thursday. The last meeting will be at the end of January. An extra webinar about MPN and corona vaccines will follow in January or February. What are we missing now? I remember this lucky coincidence at the MPN Horizon 2016 in Belgrade. On the way from the airport to our hotel in the shuttle bus, Claire Harrison came sitting beside me. After 2 minutes, we were in the middle of a conversation about ruxolitinib. And in 2 minutes, you get a better feeling for a person than you ever will get in a Zoom conference or looking at a YouTube video of half an hour. It's an experience everybody knows. Like the first meeting with your physician, you feel after seconds if you will stay with him. Also in Belgrade, on the bus tour to the restaurant, there was a Brazilian girl sitting beside me with an orphan disease I never heard before. At dinner, I talked to a Polish lady. Leonard Cohen had just died, and we both liked his songs. Again in the bus, on the way home, I spoke to John Jensen, who was or is still running the Danish MPN group. It was exciting and encouraging to meet all these people who all have the same mission to improve living with a rare disease. And all that happened by coincidence. We are missing these unexpected encounters, the talks in front of the hotel during the 5-minute cigarette break where you make friends, the networking at lunchtime. In the German group, there are some ladies, friends since years, who go out during our meetings for therapeutic ice cream eating. That's how they call it, therapeutic ice cream eating. A beautiful idea. It shows us what we have lost for the moment. All these tiny little things which connects us in an unspectacular, but very helpful and sometimes also funny way. The analog way to enjoy life. A little digression, as tiny replacement of these little pleasures, many of us started to mail jokes. WhatsApp and other messengers became an important channel for our daily contacts and exchange. Here an example of the popular cat videos. Videos are sometimes politically not correct. I like to close with Katharine Hepburn, the American actress. Katharine Hepburn said, if you obey all of the rules, you miss all of the fun. Thank you to the cat. Tomorrow, we have learned the corona pandemic is a marathon, not a sprint. My neighbor, a lady, is working for the EMA, the European Medicines Agency. She talked in a video conference to 800 people all over Europe. All were at home. Imagine the time and money they saved for not traveling. Bill Gates told the New York Times what he expects for the future. Business travel will reduce to 50%. Virtual meetings will fill the gap. Life goes on. We have to mix both worlds, the old and the new, digital and analog. Today, psychologists tell us how to treat Zoom fatigue. And tomorrow we will meet again face to face. I hope at Horizon 21, and we will eat ice cream. Thank you for listening. Once more, thank you to the cat. Now I would like to know, what are your experiences? What do you need? Thank you.